Welcome to News. Let's get to the top five headlines for today. The Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched a national animal disease control program in Mathura. In the Unnao rape case, judge records the statement at temporary court at AIIMS. Blast at US Embassy in Kabul on 9/11 anniversary. Truck driver issued a 1.41 lakh challan by the Delhi police. Donald Trump fires National Security Advisor John Bolton. Let's get to know them in detail. The Prime Minister Narendra Modi arrived at Mathura today morning. He launched the National Animal Disease Control Program. The program is aimed at eradicating foot and mouth diseases and brucellosis from livestock. The project, which costs around 12,652 crore rupees for a period of 5 years till 2024, is funded entirely by the government. The program aims to vaccinate over 500 million livestock, including cattle, buffalo, sheep, goats and pigs, against foot and mouth disease. Prime Minister Narendra Modi also launched nationwide workshops in Krishi Vigyan Kendras in all 687 districts of the country on the topic of vaccination, disease management, artificial insemination and productivity. Moving on to the next news now, where the trial proceedings in the Unnao rape case began today inside the AIIMS Trauma Centre. In-camera proceedings commenced at the AIIMS, where a temporary court was set up to record the Unnao rape survivor's statement in the case of alleged sexual assault by expelled BJP MLA Kuldeep Singh Sengar in 2017. The statement was recorded by District Judge Dharmesh Sharma. The victim is currently admitted at AIIMS after the vehicle she was travelling in was hit by a speeding truck near Rai Bareli in Uttar Pradesh. The Delhi High Court had on Friday approved recording the rape survivor's statement at the AIIMS Trauma Centre. The special judge had recently written a letter to the Delhi High Court seeking permission to hold in-camera proceedings at the AIIMS for recording the woman's statement after the doctor said it is not advisable to bring her to the court. Getting to the next news now, where a rocket exploded at the US Embassy in Afghanistan just minutes into the anniversary of the 9/11 attack on the United States. But the officials at the compound declared all clear about an hour later and reported no injuries. A plume of smoke rose over the central Kabul shortly after midnight and sirens could be heard. It was the first major attack in the Afghan capital since President Donald Trump abruptly called off the US Taliban talks over the weekend, on the brink of an apparent deal to end America's longest war. Moving on to the next news now, where with a fine of 1.41 lakh rupees, a Rajasthan registered truck has broken the record for receiving the highest fine for traffic violations under the new Motor Vehicle Act, which came into force on 1st September. According to the reports, the vehicle was fined for overloading by the enforcement wing of the Delhi's Transport Department. A challan receipt shows the number of owner of the truck. Bhagwan Ram, under the amended Motor Vehicles Act, has probably became the first truck owner in India to pay such a hefty price for traffic rule violation. Getting to the next news now, where President Donald Trump announced on Tuesday that John Bolton was no longer his national security advisor, ending a turbulent tenure marked by the widening rifts between the president seeking a foreign policy victory and a foreign policy hawk who had been deeply skeptical of much of the president's agenda. Trump disclosed the departure in a Twitter message, saying he would name a replacement as early as next week. The appeal didn't last long, however, as Bolton's opposition to elements of Trump's approach on North Korea, Iran and Afghanistan, among other issues, put him at the odds with his boss and other advisor. According to the reports, the White House has already started discussing potential candidates to replace Bolton. These were the top five headlines for today. Stay connected with News for more updates. Like, share and subscribe our channel, NYOOOZ TV. Also download the News app from Google Play Store and share your news with us.